Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 20th chapter. Here at Israel United in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
Church? You grew up in church? Okay. So, a few simple things. I just want to ask a few simple questions. I want you to be real with me, alright? Have you ever learned the laws of God? No? Have you ever learned what Jesus Christ looks like according to the Bible? Do you know what it takes to enter into the kingdom of heaven? Do you think those things are important? That's something that we should be learned in growing up in church. So, church has failed us horribly, miserably. You know what I'm saying? So, just something so simple as what Jesus Christ looks like, it's in the Bible. Your nationality, your identity is in the Bible as well. Go to Matthew 19:16 in order to get to the kingdom of heaven. I just want to jump right into it. All right, read that.
The book of Matthew, chapter 19, verse 16. And behold, one came and said unto him, Good Master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?
So there was a man that came up to Jesus Christ and asked him. He said, hey, what I got to do to get to heaven? Because you want to get to heaven, right? Because in the kingdom of heaven, we're going to be living forever. No longer have to worry about dying. You don't have to worry about getting sick. You don't have to worry about looking over your shoulder at somebody trying to steal something. You should want to aspire to get to the kingdom of heaven. Because right now, bro, we get sick. You got coronavirus going on. Unemployment rate is high. You got aches and pains going on in your body. You don't want to live like that, do you? No, nobody want to live like that. We're all trying to get to the kingdom of heaven. So there was a man that came to Jesus and asked him, what does he have to do to get there, all right?
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments.
So Christ answered him and said, listen, if you want to enter into life, keep the commandments. Exodus 20. So I'm going to ask you something. Do you know the words to your favorite song? Like if you hear it, you know all the words, right? What's the fourth commandment? Out of the 10. You don't know, right? See, you think that's important for you to know? That's something that we should know, right? So when you look at these songs right here, all right, and this is nothing that somebody, that one of us drew. These are actual accounts that happened throughout history. So when you look at these things right here, this right here is a Spanish conquistador that came over to, when you look at this sign right here, everybody below Levi, that's considered the Northern Kingdom of Israel. Those are considered the Hispanics and Native Americans. So when the Spaniards came over here during the 1492 conquest, look at it right here. He got this baby, he about to bash him against that stone. He's hanging people right there, burning them. They got another one that's bringing Catholicism to them. People that's getting thrown in pits, little babies, women, pregnant women. All these atrocities happen, and it's all accounted for in the Bible. And during this time, the things that you should know, like what we just talked about, they got taken away from you. But we're here trying to bring that remembrance back. So you would get to the kingdom of heaven. How do you get to the kingdom of heaven? Look at this red. How do you get to the kingdom of heaven? Remember the man asked Christ, and Christ said, you got to do what? Keep the commandments, right? Keep the commandments, right? So we're going to read one simple commandment, all right?
The book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 4. Verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
You know what a Sabbath day is? The Sabbath day. What is a Sabbath day? Sunday? Who told you it was Sunday? The Bible starts you there? Okay. How many days are in a week? 7, right? I want you to keep that in mind, all right? Listen to the scriptures. Start over again.
The book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor.
What's the first day of the week? Mm-mm. You look at the calendar, it starts with Sunday, right? Okay, you got Sunday. The 6th day would be Friday, okay? So the Sabbath day, which is the 7th day, has to be when?
Yeah,
Saturday. You ever heard El Sabado? Sabado, you speak a little Spanish? Right, Sabado, Sabbath day. That's when the real Sabbath day is, all right? Like I said, when all of this happened right here, like right here, this man name was Atahualpa. They came and brought Catholicism, which they also idolized the sun god on Sunday. So they worship on Sunday, which is why a lot of our Hispanic brothers and sisters go to a Catholicism, go to church on Sunday. But you can find that in the Bible. God said we're supposed to be keeping the Sabbath day on the 7th day, which is today. Read it on top of them.
Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
So God told us to remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. I want you to hold that. Go to Jeremiah 17:4. So you got to keep in mind, God is telling us to remember the Sabbath day. John, right? Roger, I'm sorry, Roger. Because you gave a perfect example, Roger. We didn't remember when the Sabbath day was. It was a point in time when we did know when the Sabbath day was. But when this happened, we forgot when the Sabbath day was and how to keep it. Because to keep a Sabbath day holy means you keep it separate from every other day of the week. And we're going to get into that. But I want to read you something historically.
Andre want to learn too.
Andre, my man. Hey, look at this sign right here, Andre, and tell me where you fall at, all right?
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 4.
Listen to this here.
And thou, even thyself, shalt discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee.
Andre, what day is the Sabbath day? Sunday? What day is the Sabbath day, John? Saturday. Check this out. Huh? I didn't hear you.
I think about that.
Yeah, think about it. Hey, it's all good. Because look, I want you to listen to the scripture real good.
And thou, even thyself, shalt discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee.
Part of our heritage was remembering when the Sabbath day was and what to do on the Sabbath day, what not to do on the Sabbath day. Look at this sign right here, Andre. All right? Do you know about this? Is this something real that really happened? Right? Historically, this happened. We got sold on the auction blocks. They took us from our families. They did all the things, had us in the field picking cotton, burning us right there. They all smiling while the man right there is in flames, had brasses, cages around our necks, all that stuff. All this is written in the Bible. Do you think that they would tell us how special of a people we were doing that to us? No. You were speaking a different language before they forced English on you. Y'all were keeping the Sabbath day before they came and did that to you, did this to us. So read it one more time.
And thou, even thyself, shalt discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee.
God said we was going to discontinue from our heritage. Our heritage also goes into the type of clothes we wear, the foods that we eat, the foods that we don't eat, how we treat one another. Being married, right? If you look at our shirts, all of us over here, we got fringes in a border of blue. That's a commandment as well. At one point in time, y'all knew that. But when this happened, these atrocities happened, our heritage was taken away from us. You understand what I'm saying? So Andre, I want to ask you, because I already asked Roger, how do you get to the kingdom of heaven?
Huh?
Follow the kingdom of heaven. Read the Bible? Sorry, I can't really understand
you. You gotta try to live by him every day, you know what I mean? Uh-huh.
Matthew 19, okay, listen to this, Andre.
I haven't forgot about you.
The book of Matthew, chapter 19, verse 16. And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?
So this is a man that came to Christ and asked him what he has to do to get to eternal life. How y'all doing?
This is Jenny.
Jenny, nice to meet you, Jenny. I want you to look at the sign and tell me where you fall at, all right? I'm gonna finish with them.
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments.
So one thing, what we have to do to enter into life is keep the commandments. So Jenny, where do you see your ethnicity here? We got my man John here, he's Issachar. Andre, what'd you say you was? If you fill out a job application, what ethnicity would you put? Judah?
Yeah.
My man from Judah. Where you fall at, Jenny?
I don't know.
You don't know? What's your father's ethnicity? You're Mexican. Would you call him Mexican? Would you call him black?
I'm Hispanic.
Hispanic? Okay. What does the word Hispanic mean? Everything that has a name has a meaning behind it. What does the word Hispanic mean?
Half white, half Mexican.
No. Hispanic means property of Spain.
That's right.
A slave of Spain. Have you ever been to Spain before, Jenny? Are you a slave of Spain? So you're not Hispanic. You got to look on here and see what God calls you right here. All these names right here are the names that the oppressor has put on us. American black. Black is a color out of the crayon box. There's no such thing as a land of black. Indian means slave. You find names like Judah, Benjamin, Levi, Issachar, Naphtali. You find these names in the Bible. You don't find these names right here in the Bible.
That's right.
So we have to come back to our nationality, Jeremiah 17:4, and understand that our true identity is what God gave us and not what the oppressor has given us. Because look, come over here, Jenny. I want you to look at these pictures that we have. These people did all, these things right here are not just some drawings that came out of somebody's imagination. These are actual accounts, things that happened in history that has been documented in the Bible and other books, other textbooks. Slavery, people that came over here on slave ships, that actually happened. We actually had people that picked cotton that was in our families. These things right here happened. This happened way before that. So when it comes to recognizing what our true nationality is, understand that it got taken from us during this time. And the Bible talks about that. Read that one more time.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 4. And thou, even thyself, shalt discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee. And I will cause thee to serve thine enemies in the land which thou knowest not.
I want to ask you something. Is your enemy a friend? Roger? Your enemy is your friend? Would your friend do this to you? Would your friend hang your sister, hang your mother, burn people? No, what about you, Andre? Would your friends do these things right here to you? Or your enemies do that? Enemies, Jenny. Would your friends do these things to you? Or your enemies?
Enemies.
Your enemies, okay. Speaking of the enemy, all right? I wanna ask y'all something. I want y'all to be real, okay? You celebrate Christmas? You celebrate Christmas? You celebrate Christmas. Jeremiah 10. This is also something that got discontinued from our heritage. You believe, obviously y'all believe in the Bible. Y'all wouldn't be standing here if y'all didn't believe in the Bible, right? So everything that comes out of here is something that we have to let register in our head and understand we have got stripped of what the truth is. We got stripped of the true image of Jesus the Christ. Because a lot of times, even if you get down on your knees and pray at night, that image right there don't pop into your head. It'll pop into your head, Andre? The image of this guy, excuse me, the image of this man right here? Does that pop into your head when you think of Jesus Christ? No. He said no. This does though, right? But you don't find this in the Bible. We're going to get into that, but read that. Dealing with Christmas, okay? Because remember, the man came up to Jesus Christ and asked him, what do I have to do to get into the kingdom of heaven, to get eternal life? It's keeping the commandments, all right? Read.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 10, verse 2.
31.
Verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel.
Hey, on the back of that flyer, we have a school, all right? If y'all want to learn more, make sure to look us up, all right? Jeremiah 10. Oh, what's your name, sir?
Paul.
Paul, nice to meet you. My name is Khalil. Where do you see yourself on this sign, Paul? What's your ethnicity? What do you put on a job application if you fill it out?
Oh, Mexican.
Mexican?
Hispanic.
Huh?
Hispanic.
Hispanic, okay. You believe in the Bible, right, Paul? All right. So what we're reading here with Andre and with John, Roger, is that in order to get to the kingdom of heaven, we got to be keeping the commandments. Mr. Paul, do you celebrate Christmas? You do? All right. We're going to read about Christmas right now. All right? Read.
Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen.
Okay. What
is
it? Nehemiah 5 and 9?
Nehemiah 5 and 9. Yeah, hold that. Nehemiah 5 and 9. So we're going to learn a little bit something more about that word heathen. Because God said, learn not the way of the heathen. Okay? Let's see what the heathen is. Remember what I asked you earlier about your enemies. All right?
The book of Nehemiah, chapter 5, verse 9.
Yeah, that's it.
Also I said, it is not good that ye do, Ought ye not to walk in the fear of our God because of the reproach of the heathen, our enemy?
The heathen are who?
Our enemies.
Is that good? The heathen your friend? No, the heathen is our enemies. These people right here that did that consider heathen. So now go back to Jeremiah. One more time. Hey, make sure to check that flyer out, boy. All right? That's good stuff. Yes, sir. Check that flyer out. Hey, don't be celebrating Christmas either. Read.
Thus says the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven.
Hey, what's going on, my man? What's your name, bro?
Terrell.
Terrell, nice to meet you. My name's Khalil. Hey, you believe in the Bible?
My dad a preacher.
Your dad a preacher? And what church?
Shreveport, Louisiana.
Okay. Does your dad celebrate Christmas? You celebrate Christmas? Y'all grew up celebrating Christmas. All right. Is Christmas a biblical holiday for us to celebrate? It's not? So should we be celebrating Christmas?
Through the Bible, yeah.
Through the Bible? Okay. We're going to read about Christmas right here. Hey, listen. We're going to read about Christmas, all right? Read.
Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them.
That's real good, my man.
For the customs of the people are vain, for one cutteth a tree out of the forest.
Hold on. What's a vain custom?
For one cutteth a tree out of the forest, the work of the hands of the workmen with an axe. They deck it with silver and with gold.
What does that sound like? Cutting out a tree. Yeah. Cutting out a tree and taking it with silver gold. Ma'am, my sister, what's your name?
Valerie?
Yeah. Valerie. What did that sound like? Were you listening?
Kind of.
Okay, we'll read it again. Hey, you knew what that was, right? Right? Yeah, I saw you smile. Okay, read.
For the customs of the people are vain.
Vain meaning it's not profitable for you. It's a lie, okay?
For one cutteth a tree out of the forest. The work of the hands of the workmen with the axe.
What custom do we cut a tree out of the forest? Do we do that on our birthdays? Nope. Do we do that for Thanksgiving? Do we do that for Valentine's Day? Nope. Keep reading.
They deck it with silver and with gold.
What's that sound like? Cutting out a tree and decking it with silver and gold. I know he know. What's that sound like, Valerie?
Decorating it for Christmas.
For Christmas, right? You celebrate Christmas? God's telling us we're not supposed to be doing that. He said the customs of the people are vain. He says learn not the way of the heathen. That's something that we're trying to bring to the realization to our people that, hey, hold that. Go to Isaiah 59 and 2. Because look, when you look at coronavirus, when you look at diabetes, hypertension, high blood pressure, all that thing, heart disease, our people that's on the sun, we run the world in those diseases. It's a reason why all of us learned that eating pig is fine. Eating shrimp, crab, lobster, and all that. We don't know that God requires a dietary law for us to continue to keep a healthy body. We don't understand that God is telling us it's a certain dress code that we're supposed to be keeping. It's a certain way that we're supposed to be treating one another. We don't know that God honors marriage. That's why with blacks and Latinos, a lot of us, we're not married. We got baby mamas and baby daddies running all over the place. And that's breaking up the home. So we got to understand how vital it is for our people to apply the laws of God.
That's right.
To save us, to save ourselves. Read. What I told you to get?
Isaiah 59.
59 and 2, yeah.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 59, verse 2. But your iniquities have separated between you and your God.
What's another word for iniquities? What about you, Valerie? What's another word for iniquity? No, no? Okay. What is sin? I gotta ask you first because you said your daddy was a preacher.
You really
want to
know what sin is?
What's sin?
We living in it.
We living in it? Okay. Valerie, what is sin? What do you think sin is?
Going against God's will.
Going against God's will. I'd like an answer. What's your name, sir?
Manuel.
Manuel, what is sin?
To me, sin is death.
Death? Okay. What about you, sis? What's your name? I didn't get your name. I'm sorry.
Jamie.
Nice to meet you. My name is Khalil. Jamie, you believe in the Bible? Okay, cool. I'm going to ask you a question. What is sin? S-I-N. Sin.
Anything that goes against God's
word. Anything that goes against God's word. Okay. We're going to read the biblical definition of sin. All right?
The book of 1 John, chapter 3, verse 4. Whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.